Did you ask yourself one time, how in the heck iFrack does that?
Right.
Or how in the world Noah does this?
Heck yeah. Yeah, they're all spawning back over here at the garage. We're just gonna laser them at range. Nice, another triple. Another two in front of me. We're gonna just drop down.
Don't you worry, because in today's video, I'm gonna share you the pro secrets. Stay tuned because I'm gonna reveal them all. Still checking in the place, still cold. Moving in the way, no place, no snow. Straight chilling with my niggas and shiver. Yo, what's up, guys? Kaiser here, and welcome back to another Call of Duty Mobile video. Today, I'm gonna share to you how to play like a pro using these 5 techniques. If you like this video, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe to my channel for more Call of Duty Mobile videos. With that said, let's get right into it. Play sensitivity. For the rotation mode, use fixed speed. Now in sensitivity settings, we have standard sensitivity, ADS, tactic scope, and sniper. Before I go further, I want you to know that every sensitivity is different depending on the device you're using. If you're using phone, use higher sensitivity. And if you're using iPad or tablet, use lower. So going back to the topic, what does these sensitivities mean? Standard sensitivity is basically known as camera sensitivity. This sensitivity is known as how high or low your camera sensitivity is while turning the camera. So if you're swiping your camera around 3 to 5 times without doing a full 360, that means your sensitivity is low. However, if you're doing a full 720 turn, that means your sensitivity is a bit too high. But when do you decrease your sensitivity if it's too high, or increase it when it's too low? The answer to that is play the game a lot. You will find the difference between high and low if you're playing a game. After playing the game 3 to 4 times, go to settings and change your sensitivity based on your play style. ADS sensitivity means this is how high or low your sensitivity is while turning the camera while aiming without firing the gun. Tactic scope sensitivity is useful if you're using a scope attached to a gun that is good for a long range. And lastly, we have sniper sensitivity. Now, based on its name, you know where it is used. However, if you like quick scoping a lot, the sweet spot in this sensitivity is around 80. I'll tell you later how to aim quicker in this video. Firing sensitivity is basically known as how much sensitivity you must use in order to control the recoil of your gun while firing. Some guns are very hard to control its recoil, and some guns are very easy to use. But what is the perfect sensitivity for controlling the recoil of your gun? The answer to that is there is none. But wait, there is a perfect sensitivity for you and how to master it. Some people tell you that there is a specific number in order for you to find your perfect sensitivity. But for me, personally, you have to experiment it on your own. How? Just play the game a lot. There is no shortcut, no specific numbers in finding your own perfect sensitivity. Learn and master every gun in the game that the game gives you, and you will find your sensitivity based on your own experience playing the game. Tip number two is pre-aiming. What does pre-aiming means? Basically, your crosshair is already aligned for you to kill the enemies. Quick tip here is just basically aim your crosshair at the middle of your screen. Maintaining that focus is hard at first, especially when moving and being shot. But once you mastered it will be a lot easier for you to get kills. And if you get more kills, it means that you also react quicker. And that brings us to tip number three, which is reaction time. Once you mastered pre-aiming, it will be easier for you to have quicker reaction time. How to have a faster reaction time? Just like I said earlier, play the game a lot. There is no secret on having fast aim if you don't put it into work. Quick tip for having a quicker reaction time killing enemies: look for the red light on the shoulders of the enemies. If you see there is a red light on both shoulders, it is a sign that is the enemy. So you need to react fast as possible before your enemies outplays you and kills you. Every second counts in Call of Duty Mobile, so make every shot and second counts. And for the last tip, we have pre-firing. What does pre-firing mean? Pre-firing simply means that when you already aligned your shot at the enemy, all you have to do now is trigger the firing button. This technique is easy to master once you mastered free aiming I told earlier in this video. Pre-firing is used when you're 100% sure if the enemy is nearby and coming towards you, or in other words, rushing you. It is mostly done in close to mid-range fights, but it is very difficult to do if the enemy is at long range. I recommend doing this technique once you mastered pre-aiming. If you snap your enemies quicker while pre-aiming, then this technique will be a lot easier to execute. And if you've done this very well multiple times, I promise you, you will get a lot more kills. And congratulations if you reach until the end of this video, because I will tell you the most important tip to develop your game even more. And that is practice. Yes, there is no other way to improve your game but other than practice and play the game a lot. What do I mean by that? If you're just starting out to play the game, or if you played the game multiple times but you want to improve more, just play the game a lot. Play against bots if you want to try something new or if you want to improve your weaknesses. Most pro players in any sport, whether it is on esports like Call of Duty Mobile or athletic sports like basketball, they improve their game to the highest level because they put time and effort to practice. Every person in this world is gifted with talent, whatever that talent is. So if you want to play like iFerg, Noah, Hawksnest, Jocasta, or any pro players in Call of Duty Mobile, you need to put effort, time, and play the game a lot. Improve every mistake you made every game and ask yourself, what can I improve more? Or, where did I done wrong that I should have made very well last game? If you answer those questions by yourself, mentally, believe me, you will be like a pro in no time. I hope you learn a lot in this video, and I hope I cover everything you need to know to develop your game. If you think I forgot something important to tell you, please comment down below. Thank you for watching the video, and don't forget to smash that like button if you enjoy watching this video, and subscribe to my channel for more Call of Duty Mobile videos. That wraps up everything, guys, and I'll see you next time. Have a nice day and peace out.